We finish off our discussion of stability and of long-time behavior by considering what happens with second-order ordinary differential equations. That is, systems that look like the second derivative of a vector is a matrix times the vector. Now, we've seen that whenever we have a system like that, every eigenvalue of A and every eigenvector gives you two terms in the expansion of x of t. If you have a positive eigenvalue, then we're used to saying that the coefficient of the eigenvector is some constant times the cosh plus some constant times the sinh. We could just as well express that coefficient as some constant times e to the kappa t plus some constant times e to the minus kappa t, where kappa is the square root of the eigenvalue. Now, in the long run, unless this happens to be zero, this term is going to grow. This term is going to shrink, but this one's going to grow. And so the whole thing grows like e to the kappa t, and it's unstable. So whenever you have a positive eigenvalue, you say it's unstable with a growth going as e to the square root of lambda times t. And this is what you have whenever you have a ball at the top of a hill. You bump it a little bit, and it falls off, and falls off faster and faster and faster. Now, there are trajectories that crawl up the hill and get closer and closer and closer to the top and closer to the top and closer to the top that correspond to that. But generically, that doesn't happen. That's saying that the first coefficient was exactly zero. It's never exactly zero. It's always slightly positive or slightly negative. And so the ball reaches the top and falls down the other side. Whatever it is, it's unstable. It runs away faster and faster and faster. If you have an eigenvalue that's negative, then we define a frequency to be the square root of minus the eigenvalue. So if this is negative 4, the frequency would be square root of 4, or 2. In other words, the square root of the eigenvalue is an imaginary number, I omega. And where we get the coefficient of the eigenvector is something times cosine omega t plus something times sine omega t. Or we could just as well express it in terms of exponentials. E to the I omega t, that is e to the square root of lambda t, and e to the minus I omega t, that is e to the minus square root of lambda t. Now, whether you think of it as cosines and sines or as complex exponentials, these don't go anywhere. You wait a million years, and this term is exactly as big as it ever was. All it changed was its phase. This term is as exactly as big as it ever was. This goes up and down and up and down and up and down, but it doesn't grow or shrink in the long run, and neither does this. These are all neutral modes. That describes what happens if you have a ball rolling at the bottom of a hill. If you give it a little bit of kick, it goes back and forth and back and forth and back and forth and back and forth forever. It never escapes the well, but it never settles down either, at least not if there's It'll settle down if you had friction, but these equations are describing a system with no friction, and it would just go forever. That's what we call neutral. It doesn't grow, it doesn't shrink, it just keeps on going back and forth and back and forth. And the last case is if the eigenvalue is zero. This would describe a ball rolling on a flat track. It rolls and it keeps rolling, 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 and it doesn't speed up and it doesn't slow down, and its position is a constant plus a constant times t. We call this borderline, but it's not borderline between stable and unstable. It's borderline between neutral and unstable. It actually does grow. It just doesn't grow exponentially. It grows merely as t to the first power. So bottom line, if any of the eigenvalues are positive, the system is going to be unstable. Because if any of the eigenvalues are positive, you're going to have one term in your expansion that goes as e to a positive number times t. And the dominant mode is whichever eigenvalue has the greatest positive, which is the most positive. But if all the eigenvalues are negative, then there is no dominant mode because the system is neutral. None of the modes grow, none of the modes shrink. They all just oscillate back and forth and back and forth, and there's no one mode that you would call dominant. Finally, I showed you a chart in the previous ones where you had which part of the complex plane was stable, which was unstable, which was neutral. For our second order systems, the matrices almost always have real eigenvalues. So I'm not going to draw the whole complex plane. I'm just going to draw the real line. The eigenvalues that are bigger than 0 are unstable. The eigenvalues that are less than 0 are neutrally stable. And 0 is borderline. So that's the story for second-order differential equations.